In previous video, we made a tutorial on how to make Thanos portal effect using 3.js. This time, we will show you how to use the same technique to turn it into a realistic raining scene in just a few minutes. So, let's check it out. First, let's begin with downloading the latest version of 3.js and include it to the page. Next, create a 3.js scene. Then, create a camera. I'll use a perspective camera with 60 degrees field of view, using current viewport aspect ratio and 1000 unit viewing frustum. I will also set the rotation angle of the camera to look up into the sky. Next, I'll add two types of light here. The first one is ambient light. This will illuminate all objects in the scene from all directions. The second is directional light. This will represent the moonlight in the sky. Next, I will set up the WebGL renderer using current viewport size. Then add it to the page as canvas element. Now the basic setup is completed, but there is nothing to see at this time. We'll start with adding some clouds. In 3.js, we need two things to create 3D objects. First is geometry, which defines the shape of the object, and another is material, which defines the surface and texture. For the cloud, I will use this smoke image as texture. Let's set up the texture loader. In the callback function, which will trigger when the texture is loaded, we will create a geometry for each cloud as 500 units plane square. Then create a material and map it with the smoke texture. Also set the transparent to true. Now I'm going to create a loop to randomly add each cloud to the scene. First, create the cloud object from the geometry and material above. Then randomly set the position. I will set the cloud rotation angle to face the camera. Also add a little bit of random around the z-axis. Then I will set the 60% opacity and add it to the scene. Next, let's try animating the scene. First, I will keep the reference to each cloud in the array. Then, in the animate function, I will use the array to rotate them one by one. Then render the scene and start the animation loop using request animation frame. Next, I will add some lightning flash. Let's set up a point light with blue color. I will position it behind the cloud and add it to the scene. Then, in the animate function, I will add a logic to random the flash position and light intensity. You can change these numbers in the if condition to adjust frequency and lightning intensity. The cloud is ready. Next, I will add rain. This will be a little bit different from adding cloud. We are not going to create a separated object for each raindrop. That would be very inefficient and you might get a frame rate drop. Instead, we will create just one object which has lots of vertices and each vertex represents one raindrop. So I will create a loop to create each vertex using vector3 object. We will random the position using method random. And then use vertices.push to add the vertex to the geometry. Then I will create a rain material using point material class. Set the size and color to white and transparent to true. Finally, we will create a rain object and add it to the scene. Now, we will animate the rain by adding velocity property to each raindrop. Then, in the animate function, we will move each drop and increase the velocity to simulate the gravity. Also, reset the position if they are outside the screen. Finally, I will add some fog as a finishing touch. Also add a small rotation to the rain object to create a cinematic effect. And that's it. If you love this tutorial, please help share this video to support our channel and keep us going. Like or subscribe to stay tuned for more. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!